Hey there, Bruno here from Landbot. A chatbot survey is a traditional survey presented to the audience as a conversation. Instead of answering to static questions, the users are invited to engage in a conversational exchange with a bot persona. So, we'll divide this video in two sections. First, we will see why you should use survey bots over regular forms. Secondly, we will build a survey bot without coding right here on the spot. So let's get into it. Why use a chatbot for your surveys? I listed six reasons. So, first one, chatbots are proactive. Chatbots initiate conversations with users as they arrive, actively engaging with them through relevant form fields. On the other hand, forms are static. The users have to go through different fields without any interaction, and so they won't have control if they finish or not the form. Second reason, chatbots reduce bounce rate. Chatbots have the power to mitigate web and mobile bounce rates using the power of conversations. Multiple marketing research studies confirm that chatbot surveys can, in some cases, double or even triple conversions compared to regular forms. Third reason, chatbots' immediate gratification. Thanks to their interactive nature, chatbots can act and react to submitted data or user demands instantly. Chatbots let you take your customers down different conversational threads based on their answers. Hence, you have a chance to react to particular problems there and then. For instance, if a customer complains about a problem you're aware of, you can have your bot offer them a discount voucher in the middle of the survey. Fourth reason, chatbots serve multiple purposes. They can be designed to enhance data collection by providing support, qualifying leads and scoring them, or assessing through the process. On the contrary, forms have one purpose at a time, simple and straightforward. Forms cannot offer friendly assistance nor stray from their single purpose when necessary. Next reason, multi-channel. Chatbots let you go where your customers are to get the necessary data across all devices and channels. Forms are exclusive to web. They require to drive your users to a certain location, meaning that you will lose some of them in the process. On the other hand, in Landbot, chatbots can also connect with users and ask for feedback directly on WhatsApp, Facebook, or API chatbots. This way, you can make your service part of the experience. And last reason, chatbots can track specific goals. You can set goals to easily analyze, track, and optimize their performance. Forms, in terms of measurability, are difficult to determine their success in achieving their goals. This is perhaps one of the most unique attributes about using a bot to collect customer feedback. With a traditional survey, you can know how many people accessed it and submitted it. However, you won't know what happened to those people that left it unfinished. Bot analytics are more thorough and let you follow customer behavior throughout the questionnaire. You have the opportunity to identify points of friction and improve your conversation flow. Now, let's move on to the next section. Let's build a survey with Landbot. I just logged into my Landbot account and I'm here in the dashboard. I'll go and click on Build a Chatbot. Here you can choose a different channel. I'll choose web for this example. Now, I could start a bot from scratch if I wanted to, but I'll choose a template. Okay, so now we're inside the builder. As you can see, the flow starts with the welcome message. It then asks for the name, email, and then comes three random questions. At the end, there's a goodbye message with a GIF and a spreadsheet integration to save the answers typed in by the user. I will actually, before anything, set up the spreadsheet block so it's set and ready to go. I linked it with a sheet I already created before on my Google account. Now, this template is fine, pretty simple with just three questions. But I want to make some changes. First, at the end, after the spreadsheet block, I'll add a Slack notification block. This way, my team and I get notified when a user finishes the survey, with all the answers laid out in the message. Now, let's say this template will be sent just to a specific audience. An audience you may already have on MailChimp, Intercom, or any other tool. You can use hidden fields and skip the first two questions from the bot, these being name and email, since you already have them on your other tool, and make this hyper-personalized bot. Let's do that. So I will delete these two blocks, head to settings, hidden fields, and finally add the variables here. Click on apply changes, and head to the welcome message to add a hi at name as the first message. Now, let's preview the bot. Let's save, publish, and go to the share section, then share with a link. As you can see, it's not giving a name. That's because it's not added to the URL yet. Now, how you add the variables into the URL depends on the tool they come from. Just for testing, I will do it like this. Let's refresh. And as you can see, it chose my name without me typing it. That's because a URL can be used to pass information from one place to another. In this case, it would be from another tool to Landbot. Great, let's answer the form. So, Adam Sandler, he's funny. A Lord of the Rings remake? Hell yeah. Best Christmas movie? That has to be Home Alone. Great, that's all. As you can see, a Slack notification popped up. And the information is saved on my sheet. I know hidden fields are a bit complicated and overwhelming at first, but trust me, if you learn about them, you will do amazing things. So I've left you a video in the description so you can learn more about it. I'm Bruno, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.